Hello again. It's Senator Zeron here, the Gae-Mes. Welcome back to another episode of Socially Awkward by Munchimat. Today will be the 8th episode. And yeah, last time we went to Bic Mac's gym again, but this time we actually got to train a little, because Bic Mac, being the personal trainer that he is, knew that we should eat something before training. Unlike Tom, who also trains a lot, but he didn't know that, apparently. Anyway, after that, we went to school again, and the same stuff from Tom's route happened again. But this time, instead of Tom, David stepped in to help us. He rained swift justice upon Cole, the asshole teacher, by making him think he's going crazy, by just tapping on the shoulder or something from behind. It's just so funny. Anyway, that is the official formation of the three musketeers, how Bic Mac put it. And you can actually start to see that Jace, John, and David actually kind of become good friends. Especially John and David, when they work together, they can do a lot of mischief. Just good that Jace is there to tell them how to stay on the side of good. Anyway, let's continue with this, with the Maccon route. Well, I'm gonna check out that new chick first. Fried chicken place. Wanna come along, Zenry? I'll have to pass. Aw, weak. Why? I don't think I have the energy for a mall trip. Right now, I wanna take a nap. Fine. What about you, Davy? Wanna come along? Either from fear or disgust, David shakes his head for a hard no. Fine, be that way. I'll start my own housewarming with blackjack and hookers. Well, that's that. So, where do you go for a nap? Office. Back at your gym? He nods. Must be nice to have air conditioning every day. I feel like getting a snack. No anywhere good? Cold preferably. David looks up to the side, seemingly looking for a place in his head. Then he nods and gestures you to follow him as he starts walking. Woo! It's kinda interesting how a lot of Maccon's round is just Jace hanging out with David. It really just makes me want to have a David round even more. I mean, don't get me wrong, Maccon is great too, and Tom is my favorite still, but David is just such a cutie too. And here we are again at the red food truck that Tom brought us to. But I think Maccon's route did it first. So, yeah. A 15-minute walk up the mountain just near the school. David took you to a red mobile food store on a flattened cliff area. Half the tables and chairs are occupied by either students or tourists, eating their vanilla ice cream while enjoying the scenery of the city. Nice place! Yeah. That's, you know, that's Miguel, but I actually haven't given him a voice before. So, ¿qué tal? I can't speak Spanish, by the way. So, I'm sorry in advance. ¿Qué tal chiquillo? A brown Mexican coyote sticks his head out of the van and waves at David. Who's this, gato? David raises ID to your coyote. Classmate, eh? ¿Estás sonriendo? Guess he has adults for friends. Wonder what they are talking about. The coyote faces you with a scowling face. Huh? He keeps at for a few seconds until... He bursts out laughing and made the biggest smile a canine could draw. Disculpe. You have to forgive me, little gato. I never thought I'd see the day little David would bring a friend over. Okay. The coyote places a finger under his eye as he shed a tear. But where are my manners? I'm Miguel Juliane, David's cousin twice removed. And you are? Full introduction, partial introduction. I feel like it's important because family is important to Mac. So, full introduction. Sir Cap, David's friend. No removals. Wait. No, that was David. And Miguel. Like this gato, lacks confidence, but very brave. So, any more surprises I should know about? David shakes his head. Just one. That's alright. It's good to finally see you making friends again, cuz. Though, I thought it'd be a girl first. See? He could be gay. Come on. Miguel softly jabs his elbow at David's shoulder as some sort of bond. David replies with the same annoyed look you've seen multiple times for the past 2 days. The little wolf reaches his hand to an ice cream poster and starts slapping his hand on it. You could tell me you wanted ice cream, cuz. David's eyes pierce into Miguel's psyche, causing him to step back in horror. You have your mother's piercing eyes, David. It is as if she was here scolding me again for taking that last empanada. Miguel steps forward and composes himself. As a celebration for your newfound friend, it's on the house. I hope your friend's not lactose intolerant. But here's a cat. Cats love them all, don't they? Yep. Yeah, that's what I like to hear. He turns away and heads back into the mobile food store. A loud humming machine rattles from the inside. A minute later, Miguel comes out with two large cones of perfectly swirled vanilla ice cream. Here you go! Woo, thanks! And the licking begins again. Look at that gato go! Only the first one's free though. I got a business to run, you know? Better finish yours before he asks for another. Miguel walks away laughing to his station as new customers start to form. Thanks for the ice cream, David. A few minutes later. That was really good. Tastes much better than the ones you get in store. David simply shrugs. I know you don't like to talk, but can you like give a thumbs up or something? And so he did. He raised his hand in the form of fist and slowly raises his thumb from his Fingery prison. Yeah, I don't have to sign. Never mind. So, what do you want to do now? David looks down at his phone, checking the time. Cleaning. Cleaning? Cleaning the gym. Ho ho! Did I gain a level in friendship? David scoffs and throws his arm forward. When's the last time you talked to someone with two words? Again, David throws his arms forward and protests. Anyway, need any help? I got nothing else to do this afternoon. Surprised, David kept staring at you as if you were some sort of endangered species. He gave it some thought, but later looks at you with a raised eyebrow. What? Even after 2 seconds, he's still staring at you. If you don't wanna, that's fine. Curses! I wanted to see my car again! Of course you did. He gives it some more thought. Then he shrugs. He has his hand upward to come along as he starts walking up the mountain. Success! And David knows, he knows. The gym is twice as busy as it was this morning with all ages and species combined. Huh, more people here. Let's scan the competition. You dart your eyes around for the toughest, thickest, burliest man in the room. But before you could examine all the contestants, you hear David whistling from the office. Soon you will all be in my tier list. Inside the office, you see Maccon getting ready to smash the monitor with the keyboard over his head. Gasp! The SSS tier himbo! Smash it! Smash it! The way you smash me! Oh my god, Jace, stop. Unfortunately, with David's power, you weren't able to see your fantasies coming to reality. Mama! Uh-huh. Oh, Davey. Davey, you're back. Computer's acting up again. I wasn't going to break it. Again. Finally, Senpai notices you.
Subarashi.
Zenri, what are you doing here? Are you here for a workout?
I told David I wanted to help.
You want to help?
Yeah. I didn't have anything to do this afternoon. Might as well spend it on doing something. Even if it's cleaning.
Cleaning? We only start cleaning after 10 in the evening.
I can't stay that long.
David protests by slapping the back of his hand to his brother's meaty biceps and then points upwards.
But I need your help filling out a form. In that.
Maccon leers at the computer with a high amount of animosity.
A computer illiterate himbo?
QUADRA S TIER HIMBO!
David pushes his brother off the computer as impossible as it may sound and rummages underneath the table. He lifts up the stack of folders and documents, drops his next to the folder and starts typing.
Gracias.
David. You are the smart one, aren't you? But you're smart and cute. And Maccon has the strength and the looks, I guess.
Get out. Shoo, away.
You wonder how a small figure like David could push a mountain so easily. Yeah, David can't stand the flirting around him. Just pushes him away. Until he hears you with those angry motherly eyes. But he soon calms down and leaves it with a sigh. He then walks to the what appears to be the broom closet. After rummaging a little bit in the broom closet, he hands you 3 things: a broomstick, a mop, and a condom. Before you could protest, David kicks you out of the office with a shove and locks the door. That totally gives me the I like you, go to my house and fuck my brother vibes. If you know the reference, you know. Well, I guess less a reference, just more of a, maybe a meme. Anyway, it's the same thing. Just here, take this condom. If you fuck my brother, use it. What happened to you?
Nothing.
Why the fuck did David give me a condom? As your mind swims around the possibilities as to why David gave you a condom, Maccon glances at the tools you're holding. I guess David wants us to clean. Is what you should have heard, but with the condom still fresh in your mind, this is what you heard. I guess David wants us to be clean. But I don't think we can finish before the end of the day.
We can still try. I'm not picky.
It's too big. Plus, I haven't cleaned it in a while.
I don't mind.
You're pretty eager. But you'll change your mind once you see it.
I'd never.
Wow. I thought normal people would try to talk their way out. But seeing you like this, it's getting me pumped as well. Let's start right now.
Yes.
Let me just get a bucket.
And Jace has dead eyes.
After realizing that everything he said was correlated to cleaning, the heavy blanket of disappointment and embarrassment weighs down on you as you sweep the dusty second floor. All that is left is the pent-up sexual energy converting to another form, proverbial imagination. As Maccon rummages and collects familiar merchandise in a huge box, he effortlessly picks it up and places them just on his belly to support the weight. The gym buff walks down towards the stairs to the first floor on a very slow but steady pace, making sure that he balances the weight of the things he's packing. While Maccon was packing heavy weight and sweat, you can't help but swallow at the sight of Macon's white backside. The glistening, sweaty, muscular back tastefully pronounced by the tight, sweaty tank top. If this was a steak dinner, it would be the highest quality of Wagyu beef. Perfect amount of fat on muscle. You felt your grind tighten and this caused you to cross your legs, sweeping the broom almost aimlessly left and right, just tossing the dust wherever. You can't help but let out a little drool at the side. While Maccon starts going down the stairs, this is the perfect opportunity for you to inspect the guy's shoulder and butt as it squeezes and tightens, jiggles slightly after each step downwards. Until he's done, once again enveloped in a blanket of disappointment.
I'm such a loser.
You reach into your pocket for the condom, you sneer it, sending all of the malice to its inanimate sex object, and this inanimate sexual. It's your fault! You did this to me! Because of your lies, I'm now a monster! You brought this upon yourself! Have fun living in my locked jaw! A giant wagyu jumps from your surprise as you pocket the condom out of sheer terror.
Sorry, I scared you.
It's fine. What you need? Boss?
Boss? I don't even pay you! You're not asking for payment, are you?
What? No! I was just playing!
I just wanna thank you.
You're welcome.
No. Like, thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Want to thank you for on behalf of my family.
Okay.
What I'm trying to say is, thank you for making David happy.
Welcome.
Why is this so hard? I'm usually good at this.
Sorry.
Gah. Now I got you to apologize. What I'm saying is, please stay friends with David.
That's real not up to me.
I know. But this is such a big development. I don't want to lose this chance.
You made it sound like he never smiled all his life.
Girl.
I'm sure he's happy without showing it.
Even in our family photos, he never smiled. Not even on his birthday.
No way. You had an epiphany of your own family photos. Whenever dad is the one taking pictures, he always makes everyone look professional. No emotions, no happiness, no bunny fingers, not even a goofy smile, just sad smile.
Maybe he has a good reason?
How long has he been like this?
6 years.
Are you sure it's not just teenage angst?
I wish it was the case. But, no. This is after Padre died.
I'm sorry. I guess that's why.
Thank you. And again, I make you apologize. Listen, you probably guessed it by now. I want David to be happy again. I can't do it because... Let's just say we have different ways of mourning our dad. That's why I'm begging you. Stay friends with him, even if he plays a prank on you.
I hope David doesn't blow up my ass for a prank.
Please.
Whoa now. Like I said, it's not up to me. It wouldn't be genuine if we faked befriending David. I don't think he would like that if we are really friends. I don't think he would like that if we were really friends.
You're right. I've been so worried about David that I didn't think straight.
Leave it to me and John. Well, John's probably the best candidate keeping David in check.
I think David's more attached to you than John. He did bring you to Miguel's place.
How do you know that?
Oh, Miguel texted me. It's why I asked you to stay friends with David. He's the only family member David trusts. But don't tell David that Miguel's been spying for me.
Promise. You're pretty nice to your brother. Tom would conk John in the head without much thought.
I got a feeling he would. But he never talked about his little brother. Or maybe he did. He mostly talks about you, really.
Me?
Oh, yeah, he's very fond of you during his time here. Mostly after drinking. You should see him drunk, he's so mellow. And really loud. But we had a ton of fun with it.
Tom's a loud drunk? Would like to see that. Yeah, I would also like to see that. Tom just being drunk and then just... Like attacking Jace and confessing his love to him. Something like that. But also, it's really nice how Maccon is like still kind of rooting for Tom right now, I guess. Like, he's hinting so hard at Tom's crush at Jace, and Jace is just as dense as any visual novel protagonist. Also, he has only eyes for Maccon in this world, I guess. Another thing, what Maccon said before, what Bic Mac said before, how David is also very fond of Jace. It's just so fucking cute. It's so cute. Why can't you date him? Anyway. I have another thought, but I will save that for the end, I guess. What else can you tell me about Tom?
I don't think I have the rights to tell you more than what you already know.
Boo! Then what's with the hug?
I hug everyone in my family. Tom's like an estranged second brother to my family. Sometimes a bit more.
Care to expand on that?
Nope.
Aww.
Did Tom and Maccon like hook up at some point? Maybe? Like not serious, but like just casual thing? And that's why they are so close, maybe? Who knows?
I've seen visual novels similar to that before.
Ask him yourself, I'm not a tattletale.
Fine. But you're really not making it easier for me with David.
What do you mean by that?
How else would I interact better with David if I don't know much about his environment?
You got a point there.
Especially why David gave me a freaking condom!
I'll answer your question, but only if it's about me.
I may get some answers right now.
Okay, I remember this choice.
And it doesn't really matter that much. But I think this is the most tame one out of all the others.
As if he's... But before that, we gotta clean up. We've been here over an hour and we still haven't finished half of the room.
Right. Tuesday, 5:90 PM. Almost halfway down, the room started to glow with the help of the setting sun. Here, getting too hot. You take off your hat and strap it to the sling of your bag. A little better. It should be okay with David and Maccon. I'm sure they wouldn't care. You shake your head, whipping the sweat right off. I don't know. I think this smile of Jace is so fucking cute. Then comes Maccon from the stairs with two blue giant cups of water.
I got some cold water for you. Whoa! Shit, is he...
July 20... Oh.
Yeah, that's the cliffhanger ending.
I guess I can delete this one. Yeah, let's do that. And now read the... Is this the same? Maybe. I'm not sure if the end credit things are the same.
Did you get the smoochy scene? If you did, good job. Oh no. Oh, it's the same for Tom's route. If not, well, at least you know a little more about our main character. Big thanks to my Patreons for keeping me alive before and after the pandemic. Even though I've been missing deadlines like a lot. No excuses here, except that supposedly I was going to upload this on the day recently mentioned, but no. BLDT, my evil provider, cut off my internet so easily, but once you give them the money, they take their sweet time. Steal from them and put it in my Patreon jar. They don't deserve the money. Thanks for playing. And now the phone says Mac. Anyway... I put the itch.io page in the description, and there you can probably also find his link to his Patreon if you want to support Manchimat. And yeah, one thing I wanted to bring up again more is that Jace's kind of crush is very basic at this point, at least.
that he doesn't really have much of a connection to Maccon, except through David, which is more a connection to David than to Maccon. And also that Jace kind of sees Maccon just like, just as a hot dude and not as much as a person yet. So I hope that future updates will help remedy that, to make Jace see Maccon more as a good guy, like he obviously is, and not just as a piece of meat, like a piece of beef, which he also is, but still, he is more than that. Anyway, that's with the Mac update. I will probably, so like I said, or like you maybe know, Munchimat decided to only update Tom's and Maccon's route right now, and until he finishes those two routes, he won't update Rask or John's route, or maybe David's. Yeah, he said he doesn't plan on doing a David route, but I still keep my hopes up that David's route eventually may come out, because it's just perfect. The two can just get along so well. Like, I mean, I guess I already kind of see the like premise of the game, which wouldn't really work with David. Like, at least it wouldn't work how it is now, but I think Munchimat could manage it. Yeah, anyway, so I'm getting sidetracked here. So yeah, only Tom's and Maccon's route are getting updated, so I will probably only play those right now. So I won't play John and Rask's route until way in the future, where Maccon's and Tom's route are finished, or going on Hades or something. I'm not sure how Munchimat is playing all this. I'm not him, obviously, but yeah, I will probably end my LP here. I will play updates when they come out. The next update should be a Maccon update, so if you're lucky, you will get that soon. Anyway, what I'm gonna do with this channel after this, I will see about that. I have a lot of, like I said in my Twitter poll, I have a lot of, or I don't know where I said it, but I have a lot of visual novels I want to play, and I may put them up in a poll again. Anyway, let's see where my journey takes me. Anyway, if you like the video, like and subscribe, and have a nice day. Bye!